Hello everyone. Today I would like to show you how to render a panorama image in Blender using Cycles rendering engine. Panorama renders are useful for presenting your works to a client with a VR headset, and it is very emotional when presented in the headset, where users look at every part of the room and feel there. Or it is also useful for uploading to social media sites like Facebook. It gives much better impression than normal renders. First of all, we need a 3D model. You can use either your own or download this one from the link mentioned in the description. Once the model is ready, follow this simple step to render a 360 image. Step 1, camera settings. First of all, we need to position the camera at the center to see all the objects perfectly. And the easiest way to do this is by using a 3D cursor. First select the room, then press Shift S and click on cursor to select it from the snap eye menu. Now we have the cursor at the center. And press Shift A, click on camera to add a camera here. We also want the camera to cover all the sides perfectly. So go to End Panel Item tab, set X and Z rotation to 90 degree and Y rotation to 0. Step 2, render settings. First go to render properties, change the rendering engine to cycles. After that go to output properties and change the resolution to a 2:1 ratio. From my experience, 6000 to 3000 will be enough to give you a decent result. Now go to camera properties, change the camera type to panoramic and panorama type to equirectangular. After that switch to camera view by pressing 0. And see the panoramic view in viewport render preview mode. Since this is an interior design, use render samples at least 5 and 2, turn on Denoise data, and add a Denoise node in compositing. Finally hit F12 and wait to finish the rendering. Once it is done, you can save the result as PNG, JPEG or OpenEXR format. JPEG will be more convenient for uploading to social media platforms. And other formats are useful for portfolio or VR presentations. Also, I tried my best to include most of the information in the description. But if you know more about this topic, then please share in the comment section below. Now it is time for a time-lapse video of the entire workflow.
today.